are unable to understand why the government insists on going ahead. The prime minister that was elected was Netanyahu, was not Yair Lapid. Those who were elected were the Likud and not Simcha Rotman. Not Ben Gvir as well. It is almost too late, but still not too late. The Likud has enough decent people that can stop the madness. Ministers, members of parliament cannot only speak anonymously at this time. They should not be silent while the country is being ruined. In the life of a country, there are rare moments in which the government needs to decide whether it wants to build or ruin. I call on the Israeli government to come to their senses, to stop the legislation and come speak to us. We don't need to crash. We don't need to fall apart. There are solutions. I call the coalition. Let's go to the president's residence and have a constitution that is based on the... And we have a country that is based on agreements and mutual respect. Thank you.
All right, well, we have just heard the opposition leader, Yesh Atid party leader, Yair Lapid, speak to the press, basically saying, calling on the government and Benjamin Netanyahu to freeze the judicial reform process. Let's go to our Jonathan Regev at the Knesset. Jonathan, we've heard Yair Lapid speaking not just to Netanyahu, primarily, I think, to other members of the Likud parliamentary faction. The question is whether there'll be response to that.
It will be interesting to see. We know that two of them have already responded, those being defense minister, still defense minister, Yoav Gallant, and the head of the Foreign Affairs and Defense Committee, Yuli Edelstein. Both have already said that at this time, not necessarily that they oppose the reform, but at this time, saying it might be time to stop. We're hearing more and more members of Likud are also thinking on that direction, possibly near Barakat, possibly David Bitan, maybe others. But on the other hand, in the coalition, there are at least 14 members from other parties, those being from Jewish Power and Religious Zionism, who are telling Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, you stop the reform, we might not continue in the coalition, we might not back you on that. And even within his own Likud party, there are plenty of members who want this legislation to continue no matter what. Therefore, Benjamin Netanyahu now has to decide which side he chooses to go with. On the one hand, those members that we mentioned, Jewish Power and Religious Zionism, strongly backed by Yair Lapid, the justice minister, who's saying he will not back down on this reform at all, also threatening to resign if this legislation is stopped. This is what Benjamin Netanyahu now has to decide, at least for the moment, as far as we understand, he's not decided yet.
All right, not decided yet, but he'll have to decide soon. Jonathan Regev, thank you for that. Decide soon. There are reports now of disruptions in flights at Ben-Gurion International Airport. Keep in mind the Histadrut National Federation of Labor, the massive national union. A lot of the workers at the airport belong to the Histadrut. They have now declared a general strike. Disruptions at Ben-Gurion International Airport. It's not just a political crisis. There are economic, diplomatic, and security elements as well. I'm going to ask all of our guests to stay with us as we continue with the special news edition, breaking news in Israel, dramatic political developments. We'll be right back.